State Television Company of Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days, today's broadcast. 60th anniversary of the Declaration of the Right to Self-Determination of Armenians from Western Armenia announced in Shushi. A road in Shernak, Western Armenia was closed due to a landslide. A memorandum on the Iqdir-Nakhichevan gas pipeline. The fate of 73 people in Khzabert Hintavar is still unknown, the Artsakh Defense Army reports. Armenia is the leader of the Eurasian Economic Union due to the growth of thermal and electricity production. 100 Doors, a charity photo exhibition at the Artists' Union. Speech of President Armenak Abrahamyan on the occasion of the 16th anniversary of the formation of the National Council of Western Armenia, in the memory of Leonid Azgaldian and the creation of the National Council of Western Armenia. Why was the National Council of Armenians of Western Armenia established? To stop the annihilation of the Armenian people of Western Armenia. Why was the declaration of the National Council of Armenians of Western Armenia proclaimed in Shushi? In memory of Zoravar Andranik, as Turkish troops occupied the northern part of the Persian territory in the summer of 1918, creating a field of advance towards Baku. Occupying the Iranian cities of Makus, Salmas, Tabriz, Serab, Ardabil, and Khoi in particular, the Turks intended to send new troops to Persia via the Alexandropol-Julfa railway to attack Baku, but Andranik's detachments cut the railway in Nakhichevan, and the Turks' garrison was captured at Julfa. During the Khoi period, Armenian forces unexpectedly struck a Turkish army stationed in northwestern Iran, forcing the Turks to stop their attack on Baku and send large forces against Andranik. The Turks suffered heavy losses, but the arrival of additional forces posed a threat to Armenian division. Under these conditions, Andranik was forced to leave Khoi. Breaking the blockade, he withdrew to Julfa. Then, under pressure from a large number of Turkish troops, General Andranik was forced to withdraw from Nakhichevan and to penetrate Mount Zangezur, with the aim of breaking through and reaching Baku via Artsakh and blocking the retreating Turkish army. Some events took place in December before the perspective of the British command on the Artsakh issue became clear. On December 8, representative of Thompson, Captain Sereit, arrived in Shushi with an officer, in four cars, each with four soldiers. According to other sources, 50 British soldiers entered Shushi for the first time. The captain said that he had come to help the poor of Artsakh and to establish peace between the two peoples, and that a British army would soon arrive for the same purpose. One of the Sereit's first acts was to demand that Shushi's newly arrived regiment disarm and surrender its weapons. The interim council, presenting the history of the formation of the regiment, rejected his demand. According to the Mudros ceasefire agreement, the Turkish army should have left the Transcaucasus, but the reality was different. Andranik addressed the Karabakh command with an order to stop hostilities. The Armenian side obeyed the order in December 1918. For this reason, Shushi remained under confiscation for 86 years. What does the Yerzinka ceasefire of December 18, 1917 have to do with the establishment of the National Council of Armenians of Western Armenia? Without the Yerzinka ceasefire, there would never have been a right of self-determination for the Armenians of Western Armenia to recognize the terms of peace until independence in accordance with international law. How are the Russian decree of December 29, 1917 and the declaration of the right of the Armenians of Western Armenia to self-determination related? The Declaration on the Right of the Armenians of Western Armenia to Self-Determination presents articles that offer the possibility of implementing the Russian decree and other state recognitions. The centenary of the Russian decree, which recognizes the right of the Armenians of Western Armenia to self-determination before independence, is an opportunity to recall the content of each article. Landslides have occurred in the Shernak province of Western Armenia due to heavy precipitation. The rockfall blocked the traffic on the Shernak Bay to Shebab Highway. As a result of intensive work on a municipality and special rescue squads, the road was opened after removing the rocks. There are no victims as a result of the rockfall. The energy ministers of Turkey and Azerbaijan have signed a memorandum of understanding on the construction of the Iqdir-Nakhichevan gas pipeline. This project aims to supply gas to Nakhichevan Autonomous Republic, which has no land border with Azerbaijan. Turkish Minister of Energy and Natural Resources Fatih Dönmez said that the construction of this pipeline will fully meet the natural gas needs of Nakhichevan. Nakhichevan is currently supplied with gas by the Islamic Republic of Iran. It is noted that the project will be implemented by the Turkish state gas company BOTES and the Azerbaijani state company SOKAR. Any economic activity in the territory of Western Armenia must be carried out with the permission of the government of Western Armenia, which is absent. Therefore, this agreement is internationally illegal. The fate of 73 people in Khazabert Hintagar section is still unknown, the Artsakh Defense Army reports. According to the report, from the very first hours of the incident, urgent work is being done with the support of Russian peacekeepers to find out the fate of the servicemen as soon as possible. Contradictory information continues to be spread via various media sources about the missing Armenian servicemen in the Khazabert Hintagar section. In particular, information about 171 Armenian servicemen is circulating, which does not correspond to reality, the Defense Army said in a statement. Chief of the General Headquarters of the Armenian Armed Forces, Colonel General Onik Gasparyan, also left for Artsakh to study the issue and take necessary actions. The volume of electricity production in Armenia in January-October 2020 was 6.4 billion kWh, which exceeded the index of last year by 1.7%. Armen Press was informed about this from the website of the Eurasian Economic Union. The index of thermal energy produced in Armenia in January-October of this year increased by 47.3% compared to the same period of the previous year. The Union of Artists of Armenia will host the 100-door charity photo exhibition from December 29 to January 6, the proceeds of which will be donated to the families of several freedom fighters killed during the war. As reported by Armen Press, director of the project Khachik Yegoyan mentions that 100 photos will be presented. The cost of each is 20,000 dirhams. He reminds that 5 years ago, on December 29, a 100 doors photo exhibition dedicated to the 100th anniversary of the genocide against Armenians was opened at the Artists' Union. The initiator of the project was Khachik Yegoyan, the photographer was Ruben Martirosyan. Doors of 100 Armenian churches were painted in Western Armenia, Javakh, Armenia, and Artsakh within the framework of the project. Now I present you a song by Armenian ethnographic group called Ven. The version is available on the official YouTube channel of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.